Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to customize our site's tagline and making other necessary changes, such as inserting a particular logo into our website. So we are going to change this site tagline and we are going to insert a logo. And another thing, we are going to change our favicon, that means the browser icon that we can see currently over here. So these are the things that is to be discussed in this tutorial, so stay tuned. Now in doing so, the very first thing that we are going to do, we can see that here is the customize your site option, this big blue button here. If we click here, we will see that we can enter into this panel from where we can change our site identity, and the same thing can be achieved from this segment where this is the appearance part, from where we can see that this is the customize option. And if we click here, we can see that we can enter into the same panel where we have entered in the previous condition. Now this is the site identity. We'll be clicking here and we can see that this is the logo part. If we click here into the select logo option, this is the dialog box that has been opened so far. Now we haven't uploaded any kind of media file into our project so far. That is why there's nothing here into this media library. The very first thing, this is the upload files and this is the select files button. So if we click here, and we'll be getting back to desktop from where these are the images that we are about to upload into our website, into our WordPress website actually. So this is the brand icon. Now all we are going to do, we are going to open this one and you can see that this is the image that has been uploaded into our site. Now you may ask where this image is being uploaded. So that is why if we get back to www directory, and here from this learn simple WP content uploads 2018, this is the part where this image will be uploaded. We haven't uploaded yet, so that is why it is now showing empty. So now if we get back and select, first of all we need to select this image here. And another thing, you can add some caption here, you can provide an alt text, and you can provide some description. This will be definitely helping you in your search engine indexing. Now if we just select here, this is the crop image option that has been presently held here. So if we crop this image, we can see that the site logo is now this one. It has been appeared over here. If we just get back to our project and reload, we won't be seeing any visible changes because we haven't published this image at all. So that is why we need to publish it in the very first case, but not now. First of all, let's change this site title, just another WordPress site. So we are going to change this tagline here, just another WordPress site, to let's learn WordPress. And you can see that it is now reflecting the changes here. This is the change that we have made into the tagline. And in the final case, all we need to do, we need to change this favicon here. And you can see that here's practically the required image dimension that is required over here. It is stating that it will be requiring a 512 by 512 pixels. And you can make your image into this dimension or you can make it higher, but do not keep it smaller than this defined dimension over here, else that won't be reflected anywhere. Now if we just select an image and if we select this brand icon again, select, here's the cropping option, crop image, and we can see that this is the change that is being reflected presently. So if we now publish, it is now stating that it is published. So let's get back to our project and see here that in case of this favicon image here, it is now executing a local host server image. But if we now reload, we will see that it is now changed into the image that we have uploaded recently. Here goes the logo that we have changed here, and here goes the site tagline which states that let's learn WordPress. Now these are the things that we need to do over here. In the next case, we need to change the header image. But before that, we will be getting back to this www directory. I'm sorry, it will be uploaded into this 06 folder. instead of the 05 folder, it will be uploaded into the 06 folder, and you can see that this brand icon image that we have uploaded so far is now present into our WP content folder.